सप्तदशः सर्गः द 17th चैप्टर ततः कुमुदषण्डाभो निर्मलन्निर्मलोदयः प्रजगामनभश्चन्द्रो हंसो नीलमिवोदकम् देन् द मून् शैनिङ्ग् लैक् ए बञ्च् आफ् लिलीस् रोज़् इन् द क्लियर् स्काय् लुकिङ्ग् लैक् ए स्वान् स्विमिङ्ग् थ्रू ब्लू वाटर् साचिव्यमिव कुर्वन् स प्रभया निर्मलप्रभः चंद्रमा रश्मिभिशीतैस्सिषेवे पवनात्मजम् द मून एक्ज्यूटेड ब्राइट कूल रेज एंड रिफ्रेश्ड द सन ऑफ द विंड गॉड एज इफ ऑफरिंग हिम हिज सर्विसेस
सददर्श ततस्सीतां पूर्णचंद्रनिभाननां शोकभारैरिवन्यस्तां भारैर्नावमिवांभसि
हनुमान देन सॉ देवी सीता whose face shone like the full moon. Her face was heavy with sorrow, seeming like a heavily loaded ship in water.
Didrukshamanu vaidehim Hanuman marutatmajah Sadadarsha vidurastha Rakshasir ghoradarshanah
Looking at Devi Sita, Hanuman, the son of the wind, also saw terrible-looking Rakshasis situated at a distance.
एकाक्षीमेककर्णाञ्च कर्णप्रावरणान्तथा अकर्णान् शङ्कुकर्णाञ्च मस्तकोच्छ्वासनासिकाम्
They were of distorted features, with a single eye, a single ear, many ears covering the body, no ears, pointed ears, and nose located on top of the head.
अतिकायोत्तमाङ्गीञ्च तनुदीर्घशिरोधराम् ध्वस्तकेशीं तथा केशीं केशकम्बलधारिणी
He saw the one who was huge, one who was tall, one skinny, one with a thin and long neck, one with disheveled hair, one who was completely bald, one who was completely covered in hair like a blanket.
लम्बकर्णललाटाञ्च लम्बोदरपयोधराम् लंबोष्ठीं चुबुकोष्ठीं च लंबास्यां लंबजानुकां
One had long ears, one had a wide forehead, one had elongated stomach and bosom. One had elongated lips extending to the chin, one had a long face, and the other had distorted knees.
ह्रस्वां दीर्घां तथा कुब्जां विकटां वामनां तथा कराळां भुग्नवक्त्राञ्च पिङ्गाक्षीं विकृताननां
One was extremely short, one extremely tall, one was hunchbacked, one was frightful, one was dwarvish, and the other had a distorted face.
विकृताः पिङ्गलाः कालीः क्रोधनाः कलहप्रियाः कालायसमहाशूलकूटमुद्गरधारिणीः
These coppery-hued Rakshasis were dark, irritable and quarrelsome. They were holding spears and warhammers of black iron.
Varaha mruga shardula mahishaja shiva mukhihi gajoshtrahaya padischa nikhata shiraso parah
Some had faces like boars, deer, tigers, goats and jackals and feet like those of elephants, camels and horses. Some had their head sunk into the trunk.
Eka hastaika padascha kharakarnyashvakarnikah Gokarnir hastikarnischa harikarnis tatha parah
Others had one hand or one leg, and yet others had ears like that of donkeys, horses, cows and deer.
अतिनासाश्च तिर्यङ्नासा विनासिकाः गजसन्निभनासाश्च ललाटोच्छ्वासनासिकाः
There were some who had many noses, some with crooked noses and some without nostrils. Some had elephant-like trunks for a nose and some had noses on their foreheads.
हस्तिपादा महापादा गोपादाः पादचूलिकाः अतिमात्र शिरो ग्रीवा अतिमात्र कुचोदरीः
Some had elephant-like large feet, some had feet like that of cows,
and some with hair on their feet. Some of them had many heads, necks, breasts and stomachs.
Atimatrasya netrascha dirgha jihvanakhastatha ajamukhir hastimukhir gomukhi sukari mukhi.
Some of them had many faces, eyes, long tongues and nails. Similarly, some had faces of goats, mouths of elephants, cows and pigs.
Hayoshtrakhara vaktrascha rakshasir ghora darshanah shulamudgara hastascha krodhanah kalahapriyah.
These rakshasis looked terrible with faces like horses, camels and donkeys. They were all wrathful and warmongering, wielding spears and maces.
Karala dhumra keshischa rakshasir vikritananah pibanti satatam panan sada mansa surapriyah.
Some had uneven, gaping mouths, and some had soiled hair and distorted faces. They were always drinking and feeding on flesh. Their appearance was horripilating. All of them were seated around the trunk of a massive tree.
Mansa shonita digdhangir mansa shonita bhojanah tada darshaka pishreshtho roma harshana darshanah skandhavantam upasinah parivarya vanaspatim.
Their bodies were smeared in flesh and blood that they consume. The best of the kapis saw these rakshasis who induce goosebumps, who were sitting shoulder to shoulder surrounding the tree.
Tasya dhastaccha tan devin rajaputri manindita'am lakshayamasa lakshmivan hanuman janakatmajam.
The illustrious Hanuman watched the blameless princess Janaki seated at the base of that tree.
Nishprabhan shoka santaptam malasankula murdhajam kshina punyanchyutam bhumautaran nipatitamiva.
Devoid of lustre, tormented with grief, with a disheveled face smeared with dust, she looked like a star that falls to the ground after its punya is exhausted.
Charitravyapadeshadhyam bhartridarshana durgatam bhushanairuttamairhinam bhartrivatsalya bhushanam.
He looked at her, who was well known for the strength of her character, who is now in distress, separated from her husband, who is devoid of her excellent ornaments and is only adorned in the love for her husband.
Rakshasadhipa sanruddham bandhubhischa vinakritam viyuthan singha sanruddham baddham gajavadhumiva.
Abducted by the king of Rakshasas, deprived of her near and dear ones, Devi Sita looked like a fettered female elephant separated from its herd and besieged by lions.
Chandrarekham payodante sharadabhrairivavritam klishtarupama sansparshadayuktamiva vallakim.
She looked like the crescent moon covered by autumnal clouds and appeared faint like a musical instrument that has been in abandon.
Sitam bhartruvashe yuktam ayuktan rakshasi vashe Ashokavanika madhye shoka sagarama plutam.
Immersed in the thoughts of her husband and under the siege of these rakshasis, he saw Devi Sita, who was drowned in the ocean of sorrow in the middle of that Ashoka grove.
Tabhiv parivritan tatra sagrahami varohinim dadarsha hanuman devin lata makusumamiva.
Surrounded by those rakshasis, seeming like Rohini, who is under the influence of the grahas, Hanuman saw Devi Sita, who looked like a creeper devoid of flowers.
Samalena cha digdhangi vapusha chapyalankrita mrunali panka digdheva vibhati cha nabhati cha.
Even though she was smeared with dirt and had no ornaments on her, she looked bright like a shining lotus stalk, smeared yet untouched by mud.
Malinena tu vastrena pariklishtena bhaminim संवृतामृगशावाक्षीं ददर्श हनुमान कपिः।
हनुमान saw the doe-eyed देवी सीता covered in dirty and crumpled clothes.
तां देवीं दीनवदनामदीनां भर्तृतेजसा रक्षितां स्वेन शीलेन सीतामसितलोचनम्।
He saw the dark-eyed Devi Sita, who had a dejected face, which shined only because of her thoughts of her husband, who was protected only by her own character.
तां दृष्ट्वा हनुमान सीतां मृगशावनिभेक्षणां मृगकन्यामिवत्रस्तां वीक्षमाणां समन्ततः।
Looking at the fawn-eyed Devi Sita, who was timid like a female deer, looking hesitantly all around,
दहन्तीमिव निःश्वासैर्वृक्षान् पल्लवधारिणः सङ्घातमिव शोकानां दुःखस्योर्मिमिवोत्थितां।
With her sighs, which seemed to set the tender leaves of the surrounding trees on fire, her sorrows seemed to rise up like a wave born out of her suffering.
तां क्षमां सुविभक्ताङ्गीं विनाभरणशोभिनीं प्रहर्षमतुलं लेभे मारुतिः प्रेक्ष्य मैथिलीं।
Upon seeing Devi Maithili, who is resplendent even devoid of her ornaments, Hanuman felt immeasurable joy.
हर्षजानि च सुश्रूणि तां दृष्ट्वा मदिरेक्षणां मुमुचे हनुमांस्तत्र नमश्चक्रे च राघवम्।
Looking at her who has intoxicating eyes, Hanuman shed tears of joy. He then started praying to Lord Rama.
Namaskritva cha Ramaya Lakshmanaya cha Viryavan Sita darshana sanghrishto Hanuman samvrito bhavat.
After bowing down to Lord Rama and Lakshmana, he felt content with the happiness of having seen Devi Sita. He then covered himself to remain hidden.
Ityarshe श्रीमद् रामायणे सुंदरकांडे सप्तदश सर्गः।
Thus the 17th chapter in Sundarakanda of Valmiki Ramayanam is complete.